I'm Al Gracian from AlboPepper.com. Are you using grow lights at home? Maybe some fluorescents. What's it cost to run them? Is it worth investing in pricey but more efficient LEDs? If you're a high-end grower, you might be used to the cheaper, high-pressure sodium lights. Good LEDs require more of an investment, but in the long run, could you come out ahead? For example, recently I reviewed Active Grow's Low Pro Max LED fixture. It's not exactly cheap, but you get more light with less power compared to an HID system. So how long until the investment pays for itself in energy savings? Today, we'll quickly look at the math for determining that, but I'll show you a cool resource on my site that will do the math for you. To calculate the cost of using a light, there are three things to know. Your electricity cost per kilowatt hour, the hours of operation, and the exact wattage consumption of your light. Take the wattage draw times the hours of operation per day. This equals the watt hours. But we need kilowatt hours, which is 1,000 watt hours, so divide by 1,000. This is your kilowatt hour draw per day. Multiply by your electrical rate, which is per kilowatt hours. And that's your price per day. To know the monthly cost, multiply by 30 or 365 for a whole year of use. Boring, I know. Let's look at a shortcut to speed up the process and offer you even more information. Over at elbowpepper.com, we have a cost savings calculator. I've compiled the formulas to help you in evaluating a light or even comparing two different ones. This can help you to determine your ROI, that return on investment. For today's example, we'll reference my previous Low Pro Max LED light review. How long until they pay for themselves? Let's consider a couple case studies. First, we have Samantha from Idaho, a small-scale garden hobbyist on a tight budget wanting to grow strong seedlings. She's been using T5 fluorescents, but they've burned out, and now she wonders if it's worth upgrading to a Low Pro Max 320 LED. She starts plugging in her numbers. She'll use her light 2 months each winter, so let's say 60 days per year. Each day they run for 18 hours. Her 4-bulb, 4-foot T5s actually draw 205 watts at the wall. Her electrical rates are cheap at 10 cents per kilowatt hour. Immediately, she can see that it costs 37 cents each day to run her lights. Using them 60 days a year means an annual cost of $22. So, is it worth an upgrade based purely on electrical savings? Well, let's plug in the stats for the more efficient LED, light number 2. Same runtime, but she intends to dim the Low Pro to 85 watts at the wall as a replacement for the T5s, so the daily energy cost is only 15 cents. Now, what about the payoff period? In this third section, Samantha plugs in the cost for just buying new fluorescent bulbs. And next, the prices for the more expensive but more efficient LEDs. And there it is. To recoup her investment, it would take over 43 years of just growing seedlings for the spring. Now, the warranty is good for 5 years, but the payoff period far exceeds that. Perhaps a better option would be some T5 LED replacement bulbs. But what if she ran the light 365 days per year as a small business? At full power, this 320 watt Low Pro could replace 12 4-foot T5 fluorescent bulbs. Imagine she didn't own any fixtures yet. In a year and a half, the Low Pro would pay for itself in energy savings alone. That's with cheap electricity. What if it was 15 cents per kilowatt hour? Wow, an ROI of less than 1 year. Fluorescents aren't that efficient though. What about some high-end stuff? Let's fly over to Hawaii, where we meet up with Bernie. He's growing several large medicinal tomatoes? All his bros over at 420 Street tell him that HPS lights are the best. But electricity is expensive, not to mention cooling costs. Bernie runs the numbers. He could get a 1,000 watt double-ended HPS kit for $350. It draws 1,070 watts. But the 640 watt LowPro Max would be a suitable replacement. Average light cycle might be 14 hours. In a little over a year, Bernie has broken even. And that doesn't even include the cost savings in cooling. Meanwhile, he still has over 3.5 years left on his warranty. Well, guys, I hope my cost calculator can help you to compare different lighting technologies. This can really help you in counting the cost before jumping into a new investment. If you like this concept and appreciate the work I put into it, please give me a thumbs up. And be sure to share the resource with others to help them out. Please subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, guys, happy gardening.